Kia ora, bros and girls, welcome back to the channel. And if you're trying to finish Uncollected this month and running up against Omega Red, I've got some tips for you. Let's first look at the nodes. So you've got a region and adhesion node there. He has some death spores. He's basically immune to bleed. He's got this death factor, which degenerates and reduces your ability accuracy, but it doesn't work so well against robots. His death spores are vicinity based, his heavy attack can degen, and he's got some lifesteal and stuff. So this was my first pass through when I first finished Omega, and I was trialing with a few different team setups. This was no revives, but I ran in with Guillotine, which actually, it's not a super fantastic option, apart from she does have that heal reversal, which is great because it's, you know, he's on the regen node. So I reverse his heal here and just dance away, and he is basically degenerating himself as long as that reversal's on. Of course, bleeding him causes me to degenerate, getting close to him causes me to degenerate. So it wasn't fantastic, but you know, it got him down while I was experimenting, so that was a good start. My next thought was, okay, let me try Void, because Void has a heal reversal as well. I don't know if you guys have used Void, but he's an absolute beast. But he's got adhesions and a heal reversal. Now, of course, the lag didn't really help while I was doing this, but never mind that. And you know, he worked okay for a little bit. Of course, my strategy at this point was not refined, because I wasn't super familiar with Omega. I was just trying to do the best that I can with the heroes that I have and with my knowledge of Omega at the time. And you'll see as we go through the video that we do get a lot better at dealing with Omega. This is just kind of, you know, the first run, just to show you that even if you don't fully know what you're doing, he's a bit easier than Emma Frost, but that you can beat him. You don't need to play perfectly to beat him, but it definitely helps. It makes it a lot quicker. So again, I come in with Star Lord, and it doesn't particularly have to be a 5-star Star Lord. I'm blessed enough to have a 5-star R4 dupe Star Lord. I know a lot of you probably will look at that and just be envious, but I mean he's really a bit of a game changer. But if you have him in 4-star, maybe even 3-star, and you play him well, you could take out Omega, because the concept of Omega the ideas are quite simple, right? And after I finish this run, I'll explain a little bit, but the main things is you have a region and adhesion that you have to manage. And as long as you're not reversing the heal, then you have to hit him every 6 seconds. You want to hit him just enough for that region not to count and for you not to get degenerated. And you want to be far away enough from him that you stay away from his death spores. But you want to get in close every 6 seconds to get some hits off, so you can stop his regen, stop your degen, and every time you go in, it builds the death spore. So you can see there, I end up bringing him down with SL. But there were mistakes in that setup. So this was the first time, and I had just gone through, and I had literally, that was my uncollected completion. I was like, okay, cool. Since then, I've 100% uncollected, and I've fully finished Emera Frost and Omega Red. And there's a few different strategies for him. So first strategy is heal reversal. Second strategy is heal block, but there's not too many good chances for heal block. So Yondu could heal block him, and you could just continue going in, hitting him, staying away, coming in, hitting him, cycling through that SP1. Here's what I'm talking about. So he's got that regen, he's got the brute force. The regen timer gets removed every time you hit him. The degen means every 6 seconds you gotta hit him, right? He's got the death spores to deal damage on you. His tentacles can cause passive damage. He can degenerate. The death factor and the death spores don't work so well on robots. So, of course, if you have a vision, you probably don't even need this tutorial. You probably already finished it, because vision is probably the best counter to Omega on this node. Nebula is another really good one, but I found Star-Lord is great. Void is okay if you want to reverse his healing, but it takes a lot more thinking and a lot more management. I haven't been able to do it very nicely. He is a villain as well, so you know, Blade is okay because you can hit and go away and regen, but I don't have a high enough Blade, and I didn't find Blade that effective against him, so I used others. So here I am with Star-Lord, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to get in there, I'm going to get those hits, build up the combo, and I want to push him to his SP1. I want to get that regen off him, get him to his SP1, and then hope that he can set it off. And I'll just hit him just enough to keep him off that regen. Once he hits the SP1, I count to 5. And then I go back in, right? Because that's about how long it takes for his animation, so that you don't run in to get hit. So here I'm getting his regen. I'm going to go away. I'm going to wait for his SP1. The Dijon's about to hit me, so I probably need to get a couple of hits in here. But he goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to go in, get the regen off, hit my SP2, and continue. Now you can see the death spores counting. 4, 5, 6. Now I'm going away. They drop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I go in. I'm going to hit him. And it's just about, it's a lot of things to juggle. But if you can do it right, he becomes very easy. Stay away from his S-Pores. But I've got to get in now, because I'm going to degenerate. But at the same time, you got to wait for the right opening. I didn't wait for the right opening there, and got smashed. But I got him down a fair bit. So another really useful strategy I found was pairing Proxima with Nebula to get her to 10 electrostatic charges. And Nebula has this really super cool thing where you build up your stock electrostatic charges. And if you parry, you transfer them to the opponent and you deal damage over time. But then if you combo that with an SP2, that doubles the charges. And it does something crazy. It does something like 1500 per charge. So you're doing about 60,000 damage over 3 seconds if you double your static charges, plus 700 and something from the original electrostatic charges. So you're doing about 60,000 plus 28,000. You're doing about 100,000 damage over a very short period of time. And you'll see here, so I'm regening. I'm building up my charges. I'm at 19, now I'm at 20. And what I'm gonna try to do here is I'm going to try to parry him. He's going to come up to me now. I'm going to parry. I'm going to hit that SP2, and look how quickly he drops. Look at that, 15,000 tick damage. And he's almost dead in one shot, but he regens a little bit. Then that was from full life. Of course, if I do a little bit more damage, he goes. I end up dying in here and then finishing him off with Star-Lord. But the point being, you know, if he's at 14, 15, 18, he's quite manageable, right? You can come in there with another champ and do that. But that was basically one shot. So in this case, yeah, I think I did come in with Star-Lord. And we get our 5, push him to his SP. We go away to drop the death spores. We go back in to get the regen off and the degen off. We drop again away to drop the death spores. Count to 5. Go in past the SP1. We have to hit him here. And there we go. He's done on that one. So that was one without revives. You can use, obviously, lower level nebulas. They still do an insane amount of damage. The tricky bit is making sure that you build up the charges without parrying him, and at the same time just intercepting him enough and staying away from the degen. But other than that, I mean, that's a very useful trick if you have Nebula. So here's another example. I never actually got to one shot him with Nebula. There is a guy on YouTube that does this, probably would plays way better than me, but I never got a nice enough combination to be able to do it and not die, or not push him to his SP3 or whatever. But here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I go in, I get his regen off, I get my degen off, I dance away, I build some charges, I'm gonna go in there, drop his regen, I'm gonna go away, I'm gonna build some charges, I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna drop his regen, wait for his SP1. I'm just waiting here. He's gonna regen to his full life, but what can I do? Now he's on his SP2. He's being really stubborn this time. So I ended up just pairing him there, hitting that, hoping I could get enough damage before the SP3. Unfortunately, he hits this SP3 and pretty much destroys me. I'm lucky enough to have a 6-star and have a decent enough damage and regen to just get a few more seconds, squeeze a few more seconds damage out of that, and then I can go in and finish him off with Star-Lord. So, just to summarize, strategy is you have to go in every 6 seconds. Try to use a robot if you can. Try to stay away from him unless you're going in to hit. When he starts the SP, just count to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He'll finish his animation, and then you can go in there and finish him. Hope he's a lot easier than Emma Frost, but he is still pretty hard. You need to come in and deal the damage and don't take damage. Hopefully this helps you get through Uncollected, complete it if you haven't completed it, maybe 100% it if you've still got a bit of time over the last 3 days. That's how you 100% Uncollected. Hopefully it helped. If it did, please like, subscribe, leave a comment, tell me what you think. And yeah, we'll see you this month, hopefully. Ka kite anō, boys and girls. Ka kite anō.